What we're really focused on is prevention. There are 5 pillars of prevention. Nutrition and diet. We treat food as medicine. Physical activity. We also treat physical activity as medicine. The type of physical activity you do is extremely critical. Substance cessation. Substance abuse used to be linked to just smoking, but now we know that using things like antidepressants, opioids, and non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs like Motrin markedly increase risk. Stress management. Stress is ingrained into the American lifestyle. We'll look at ways to manage this. And prescribed medications. If you do have medications, we want to make sure that you're taking them. The MESA study also demonstrated that incremental cost-effectiveness ratio with the pulse cardiac test dropped almost a factor of 3, meaning that it greatly decreased the cost of care per quality-adjusted life. An unstable lesion has a thin cap of a single layer of endothelium, a necrotic core filled with lipids and cell debris, and shows signs of inflammation. Our goal is to convert this unstable lesion to a stable lesion with no inflammation, a thicker cap, and minimal necrotic core. There's a number of things that do that, and here are a few. Statins. Statins are primarily given for lowering LDL cholesterol. They have a side effect called pleiotropic effect, which stabilizes these lesions. It's important to note that other drugs like statins, called CETP inhibitors, cholesterol estuary transfer proteins, lower bad cholesterol, but do not reduce mortality or morbidity. Jardiance and liraglutide. The drugs are used to treat diabetes. However, they have the same effect as statins, reducing the risk of heart disease. Olive and avocado oils. For patients who've never had a heart attack or stroke, olive oil, avocado oil, and a Mediterranean diet are considered statin equivalents. They lower risk as much as drugs do and convert stabilized lesions. Kyolic 110. This supplement is made of aged garlic extract. Studies at UCLA showed it stabilized and regressed lesions. Berberine, a nutritional supplement which lowers hemoglobin A1C and LDL, also stabilized lesions. Nicotinamide riboside, a form of vitamin B3, which increases the elasticity of arteries, making them less prone to injury. Omega-3, the minimal invasive dose is 1 gram of total of EPA and DHA. It's important to use omega-3 fish oil in conjunction with olive oil or avocado oil, or to a lesser extent, coconut oil. A study showed omega-3 fish oil used with canola, soybean, vegetable, corn, grape, sunflower, and safflower oils increased inflammation. Vitamin D. Deficiency of vitamin D makes people prone to develop lesions. Riboscine increases glutathione, an antioxidant that recycles vitamin C before it becomes free radicals and damages organs. Exercise provides one of the most pronounced transitions from unstable to stable, predominantly with resistance training, not cardio. However, doctors are required to use body mass index as a measurement. Let's look at an example of what that means. These are 2 patients with identical BMIs. They are both 140 pounds. However, the person on the left has 86.8 pounds of lean muscle and 38% body fat, and the person on the right has 114.8 pounds of lean muscle mass and only 18% body fat. We all know which one's healthier. When people go on diets, 55% of the weight loss is muscle, not fat. We need muscle because it's the primary storage for glycogen, the excess energy. Resistance training helps maintain or increase muscle mass. It reduces the risk of type 2 diabetes. It lowers blood pressure. It prevents weight gain. It reduces the risk of heart disease, Alzheimer's disease, and cancer. It also improves mental health, strengthens joints, slows down the loss of skeletal muscle and calcium in their bones. Current popular diets count calories in and out. However, not all calories are equal. When we compare 100 calories of carbs to 100 calories of protein, a person will burn 25 of the protein calories to digest it, so they would really get only 75 calories. The other popular notion is that the adult diet should be 2,000 calories, but if that person doesn't move much and sits at a desk, they would need way less. If they're very active, then they may need more. When young people have greater muscle mass relative to their body size and are sensitive to insulin, this means they can store lots of energy without getting fat. As we age, we become insulin resistant for a number of reasons, one of which is losing muscle mass. If our muscles can't store all the energy it's taking in, it spills over. It goes to the liver and gets converted to triglycerides and fat. The greater the insulin resistance is, the more it's stored as fat. The bottom line is, it's okay to diet, but patients need 30 minutes of exercise 5 days a week with at least 3 days of resistance training to activate the metabolism. An unstable lesion has a thin cap, a necrotic core filled with lipids and cell debris, and shows signs of inflammation. Our goal is to convert this unstable lesion to a stable lesion with no inflammation, a thicker cap, and minimal necrotic core. There are 5 pillars of prevention: nutrition and diet, physical activity, substance cessation, stress management, and prescribed medications. Exercise provides one of the most pronounced transitions, predominantly with resistance training. Congratulations, you've completed the course.